3 feet from the top of that hole is a beehive.
This bee-chasing man with the blonde dreadlocks goes by the nickname Bizarre. And with nothing to cover himself with, he worked tirelessly to chop this tree down. To remove a 6-foot beehive with more than 200,000 American honeybees.
He's gonna cut it and then hopefully it's gonna come this way.
His co-worker held a rope to guide the tree as it fell. Dozens of neighbors stood outside to see how long it would take them. And soon enough, It was a done deal. The nonprofit group that removed the hive, Central Texas Bee Rescue, volunteered for this. They actually saved the bees and released them into a safe place. The man who lives at this house is glad they're gone.
Feels great, but it feels even better that they're going back into the environment.
Omar was never worried about the vortex of bees that shot out of the tree. Neither was the Bizarre.
You're red here. Why don't you wear like a cover or something?
Well, I do sometimes, but mostly it gets in my way.
Everybody who was hanging around to watch the tree fall scrambled for cover once it did.
It's pretty hilarious.
So the smoke, you put the smoke on him and it makes them think that they're hungry.
The Bizarre says he doesn't worry about the pain from the sting since they release collagen into the skin.
It's almost like my Botox. Botox.
Nice.
Yeah, we'll call it Botox. Right on.
Can I get stung?
Oh, yeah.
Nobody was seriously injured. If anything, the tree chopping gave neighbors something to buzz about.
I'll get it on video. I got it on video before some people got stung, but I got it.